Hello, everybody. My name is Invict Dunn. Welcome back to Balatro here on the channel. Today, we're going to continue our quest for our first E. And I have no idea how long this series is going to last. Hopefully, today is the day and it just like kind of ends. But not because I don't want to play it, but it's because I'm desperate. I want to get my first large score in Balatro. I feel like I'm the last person in the world who hasn't gotten like an integer scientific notation score yet. So we're going back to standard decks because I don't want to play the gimmick decks. I want to do this with just a regular old standard deck. So we're playing blue, just plus one hand every round. That's all we get. Should be a lot of fun. And again, thank you all very much for all the support. I really do appreciate it. Again, I'm not going to be holding R on any of these videos, just recording them live, and hopefully they go well. So yeah, so nothing fancy about the blue deck here. We just get plus one hand per round. That's it. Already starting off here with a flush. So let's see if we get an ace. Yeah, there we go. A couple people have been asking me, do I not know about the you can sort by suit or by rank or like the cards? I know that you can. I always know that you can do that. Is that blue?
We start off with a blueprint.
I'm getting distracted here. That's a freaking floor one, item room one blueprint. Oh baby, is today the day? Anyway, but people often will ask me if I know about the sorting feature down here with suits and ranks. I do know about it, but it doesn't mean I'm going to remember it. So, but yes, I do know about that you can sort between the rank and the suit. Sometimes you can figure out which suit it is based on the ranking down here of the sorting. I don't bother doing it because I can just simply look at the cards here. But sometimes it is necessary, though. So, go for clubs. We'll try clubs here. So, starting off with a blueprint start has me all kinds of excited, because what this means is that from here on out, any joker that we get is going to get doubled. And early on, I mean, this is probably like the best start that you can do. So what blueprint does is it will copy the ability of the joker to the right of it, meaning that if we get something like says like times two multi, it's going to also give another times two multi on top of that. I can't believe we're still in this hand. Get out of here. So what we're really hoping for is a strong economy and a very, very, very strong joker to start with here. And we got zero jokers. All right. All right. We can go for, well, honestly, I'm not feeling either one of these. The Mega Arcana pack is worth more than the jumbo, but we don't have enough to buy either. So I guess we'll take the jumbo. Maybe we can get ourselves a, maybe we can get a, not a fool card, but the one that gives you a free joker. You can go for a lucky card or just make another ace or a queen. Now, something else that people have been pointing out is that you don't necessarily want to be making all aces, unless if you already have like the scholar or if you have Fibonacci, something like that. You actually gain more value from making like queens and kings, which I do agree with, but if we don't have a run that's like being determined right now, I'm going to stick with aces just for now. All heart cards debuffed. Okay, so let's get rid of a heart and turn it into an ace death card here. Or we could go for an empress as well. I'm not going to take a spin on the wheel, so we'll just do that. All right, we want to get out of this hand as fast as possible with as much money as possible. Wow, we got an eight card straight. You know how hard this is to do? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack. That is extremely difficult to do. I'm just gonna... Oh, yeah. But flushes are worth more. All right, fine. No reason to play this straight. Okay, king high flush. Definitely would take that. Blueprint looking awfully lonely up there. Go for diamonds here. Gosh, we got a straight flush. Wow. This run feels different. This run feels different. The blueprint start. Oh, baby. A fortune teller is not going to help us out, but a spectral pack. If we get Ankh, oh, man. Double blueprint, and it's money. Come on now. It's It's a 1.5 times multiplier on blueprint. That's amazing. And I think I'm going to save for another Joker here. I don't know. We have the needle coming up. We have to get another Joker on this floor, or we're sunk. We'll go for a boat with kings and sevens, maybe. I'm gonna stick to kings and sevens or aces. I'm pot committed now. We didn't get it. You know, as soon as I play this, we're gonna get a king and an ace. Yep. Oh, we got our boat. It was a different boat, but we got our boat. There's our kings, all right. All right, please give us any joker, besides that one. Double Arcana pack here. See, we can trim, what is our, oh yeah, it's the needle. We can trim, or we can go, this just gives us more value here, when we don't have a lot of money, so we need value. Temperance doesn't really help us out. Empress is okay. Come on, game, don't do this. Don't be like this now. I'm gonna use the chariot card and make ourselves a steel two. I'm gonna wait on the Temperance and the Empress here. We can level up the flush if we really need to, but man, this is getting scary now, because we are not going to be able to beat 800 on just this. We have to get a Joker here, otherwise we are sunk. I'm going to wait. We're going to basically hold the Empress until the needle. Going for a diamond flush here. Ace is high. An ace's full boat is also not bad. We have more sevens in the deck than anything that, other than twos. I'm discarding the chance for us to get a flush here, going for a boat instead. Got to discard the 10. Feels bad, man. We're not going to get many points for this. Okay. Well, I wasn't expecting quad aces, but we'll definitely take it. Okay, we need, please, for the love of everything holy, give us a good Joker here. Brother, that is not what we want. I mean, crazy Joker. Let's see if the Mega Arcana can get us a card. No, of course not. We can make another ace and king here. I think that's a good idea. I guess buy crazy Joker in hopes that we get a something. Go for overstock as well. Like, either one of these is better than Crazy Joker. Yeah. I mean, just even this is better than Crazy Joker. So this is at least going to give us another multi, but with 800, I don't know, man. It's going to be challenging. We already have a flush, basically. I don't think a flush is going to do it. We need something higher than the flush. Got our ace. We should try to go hard here for more aces, though. I'm going to give up the flush because I don't think a flush is going to get us there. I think we have to go for four of a kind or five of a kind. That's a king high boat or ace high boat. So that might do it, I hope. Ace me. Okay. So I'm going to add to the multi here with the Empress card and just hope that this is enough. Don't think it's going to be. But you never know. Oh, baby. Let's go. We live. Okay. We didn't get much money, but we live. We just have no scaling right now at all. I'm going to buy the Abstract Joker. Just because it does, it just gives us more multi right now. We have the hook coming up. Three tens. There's four tens, okay. Obviously the multi on blueprint is going to go off before Abstract Joker. I can't do this because then it's not copying anything. Man. I'm gonna swing for the fences and hope that we get Joker, which we didn't. I mean, we can go for diamonds here and then get the greedy Joker. I think we're gonna have to do that. I would love to enhance the multi, but like this enhances the multi even more. Oh, we have to sell one. Yeah, we can sell the regular basic Joker, that's fine. Okay, so let's see how this works if we're playing with diamonds. We get free stuff in the next shot, but it's not gonna get any better than that, so let's just go ahead and try it. So blueprint's going to copy Greedy Joker here. And let's see what that does. A little bit better. Seeing double. So as long as we have a club that scores and any other suit, it's going to give us a times two multi. I think we have to take this one for now. We can go between Lusty or Greedy Joker and Seeing Double. The blueprint for now. Okay. A little bit worried about this. Okay, there's our flush, so let's go ahead and get this done now. We know that the hook is going to yeet two of our cards here, and that's fine. Abstract Joker's adding more to the multi because we added another Joker to our bench. That's good. Okay, so we have the potential to get money here with to-do list. We can worry about telescope later. What we can do is we can buy to-do list and at least get 10 bucks back from that because we can copy it one time with the blueprint. Blue Joker is also kind of tempting. Because that's a lot of chips. I'm going to wait on it. Ooh. Mega Buffoon, though, man. We need Jokers bad. I'm going to skip for it. If fortune teller, grow Michelle, scholar. You can get rid of, I mean, seeing double is not, it's not great here. Get rid of seeing double. I'll buy the banana. And then I'm going to get rid of Greedy Joker and get Scholar. Okay. We got to play two pair here. And we drew two pair. Look at that. Look at us. It is compatible with to-do list. This is fine. But this should theoretically get us $10 here. Yep. Okay. That one's a flush. We can definitely do that. We have plenty of diamonds in there. Can't throw away two aces. A steal. Give me one diamond. One diamond. Yes. So this is more money, and this should be. We should be okay, especially with the two of clubs down here. Oh baby, we're rolling in it now. Look at that. So now we can go. Oh, we can play two pair though. Ah, oh, more money though, man. How much is this going to be? Let's try to suss it out here. So it starts with a base of 40. So this is going to be 31, 42, 52, 62 times 2. Which is 124. But that's at the base value. And then we add 15 to that, 30 multi. So it's going to be 62 times 17, 32. $82 times 36 is $2,000. Yeah, this is way over. Yeah, so we can do the greedy play here. Oh yeah. And we lost the banana immediately. Well, we made a lot of money there. That's exactly what we needed. So let's go ahead and get telescope. Supernova. We've only played flush six times. Why is the board... Has the board always kind of floated like that? I don't know. Not really great. Banner doesn't really help us here. Get the Arcana pack. So more plus multi, and honestly, I'm fine with that. Yep. Gonna save money for rerolls here. Sun card, scary face, stencil, and there's the Cavendish. Oh, baby. Okay, so we have our times basically 9, and I don't know what this multi is going to end up being, but it's we have some scaling now, which is good. Wild Ace is nice. Give me one more. Temperance is going to give us 15 back. Technically 12 back. The family, we don't really... I mean, we have a few... We've got a lot of aces, but... Is that going to be enough for us to get... To play all of them? I don't know. We can try it, I guess. So if the opportunity arises, we can play with the Scholar 4 aces. And then blueprint whatever we need, so... Okay. All spade cards debuffed. But luckily for us, we added a wild ace. Need aces. I don't understand. We need aces. Okay. We somehow drew even numbers of suits. It's very difficult to do. Oh, that sucks. Okay, so let's get rid of these. It's just gonna be high card, which is technically going to give us some money here, so we might as well get 10 bucks. Oh my, okay, well. Okay. What do you want? Straight? No, get out of here. So, let's see what this does here by playing five aces. Let's see what this does. You want to be copying the family because it's times multi on the multi, and then also more multi. The Cavendish. We go. All right, certificate of authenticity is kind of fun. Another voucher. I'm gonna keep redeeming these until I don't need them anymore. I still don't know what this does, but that paid for that. We get an egg. I do like to mess around with the certificate. When a round begins, add a random playing card with a random suit to your hand. We can copy with blueprint, but what are the odds of us getting an ace out of that? Judgment. That's the one I was looking for. And this doubles our money. We can't copy any aces right now, so let's just double our money. Got a celestial pack here. But flush, full house, two pair, high card. None of these are fantastic for us. Yeah. Not great. We can go high card. I mean, we could be going for flushes here, but we're trying to lean into the ace play here, so. And then I'm gonna skip out on certificate for now. Drunkard gives us plus one discard, which would be nice. Flush just won't go away. Death card, absolutely. I use Pluto. Rerolls are getting a little bit expensive now, so hand size is real nice. Okay. God, I hate losing to-do lists, though, man. We want that strong economy. Get rid of Scholar? Man, this is tough. We can find other ways to get economy. Okay, all face cards drawn face down. We don't care about that. Aces are not face cards. Okay. Of course, we immediately draw straight too. I did see that game. Looking for aces here. Still looking for aces here. I guess we're playing a king. All right. We could copy the multi king. Sure. Let's do that. Do that. Because we don't technically need aces, I guess, if we have a lot of kings. Then let's make a lucky king. We all love a lucky king. Maybe we'll get 20 bucks here. That'd be nice. You did not. Strength card turns these into aces. Sure. Five of a kind would be great. Keeps giving us Jupiter though because of telescope. We need to be playing more four and five of a kind here. I guess we'll keep banging on flushes, but it's not ideal here. Give me one reroll. Is Planet X, baby. Okay. Please. Gonna play the kings. These are super great for us. It's just gonna keep giving me dupe. I don't know why I'm expecting four of a kind. Who do we have here? We got the mark. I think I'm gonna wait on the standard pack. Faceless Joker, I mean, we could get some extra money out of this if we were able to discard three or more face cards. We do need money. But I think I'm gonna pass. Okay, we got our steal two, which is good. We just have no idea if these are four kings or not. Let's play this card just to see what these two are. If this is a queen, most likely these are kings. Okay. So we gotta go hard for aces now. One king. Okay, there's our four aces, so let's go ahead and play these now. You. Blueprint over. That should be enough. Oh, yeah. Okay. This one hand per round is very good as well. I'm absolutely addicted to hanging Chad. We need money here. This isn't ideal because we don't have maximum money right now, but we need any kind of income. Love that we keep on upgrading flushes, even though we're not playing flushes. I'm gonna wait one round. We have the arm, which doesn't matter because we haven't really leveled up much. Okay, so we're gonna be going for aces here again. Standard. that. There we go. Add a door. Yeah, we could definitely use some trimming here. Trim the hedges, get them out of here. Need reroll. Well, let's see if we can get. We're not at four of a kind levels yet, but there's Mars. Joker, man, it's so tempting to take it. How many face cards do we actually have, though? We only have three kings. Never mind. Faces Joker is not worth it. Okay. Got our five of a kind here. Hope that we get 20 bucks. That'd be nice. Vermillion, okay. I'm just asking for one crazy, crazy Joker. I'll definitely take the Chariot card here. Let's buy the Arcana pack. Double our money again. Let's go ahead and get the Grabber while we have money. If this is a Wraith, I'm not taking. Well, no, I can't. Well, no, I guess we can, but. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. What we really would like to see would be a red seal or something that we can get some multi-activations with. We have Cryptid, Immolate, Enhanced Face Cards, or we can Polychrome another one. Which is obviously something we're not going to do. We can destroy five random cards or copy more aces. Which sounds to me like the best plan that we can get. Well, actually, we'd be just doing this. Create two copies of a selected card in your hand. We could make more kings, too, but we're playing aces at this point. Plus multi-aces, I like that idea. Splash is not terrible, but if we're playing four of a kind, it doesn't matter. I mean, Golden Joker is nice, but... Okay. We do have a lot of enhanced cards here. In the most perfect scenario, what is the highest that Vampire could get? Vampire gains 20% multi per enhanced card. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that's only going to be a times 2 multi. One, two, so it starts at one, yeah. So that would be times three total, because he's gaining two off of this. That's in a perfect scenario. So it'd be 1.2, 4, 6, 8, 2, 4, 6, 8, 3. 3.2 would be the highest. Which I don't know, man. I don't know if that's enough. We're already on anti six. We could go for it. We do have a Chariot card here, and maybe we get some death cards that we can add some multis to. Maybe we get Midas Mask. It feels like a little too late to pivot, though. But even then, it only just barely beats Cavendish, which doesn't require us sacrificing all of our plus multi cards. So I think it's too late to pivot to Vampire, to be honest. Using our discards here. Steel Jack. So this should be worth some pretty good bucks here. Also, I'm wondering if I should put Cavendish before Blueprint. That's probably smarter to put that there. I don't know why I didn't have that there before. Although this is getting a times four, then times three versus times three, then times four. I don't know what the better order would be there. Okay. Now the hieroglyph is interesting. Hieroglyph gives us a redo on this floor. See what we get from the Arcana packs here. Remember, we're not going for the win. We're going for the high score. The Temperance, the Judgment. Temperance gives us 17 bucks. We've got money. I am going to pop the Hieroglyph here. We lose one hand, but we have plus hand from Grabber, so I don't care about that. So we're back down to the ante, to 6 ante now. We've given ourselves another opportunity to get stronger. Okay, clubs are debuffed. There we go. That's what I like to see. Make another lucky ace here. How amazing would it be if we got 40 bucks here? I'm gonna, for S's and G's, I'm just going to see what this does to the score multiplier here. Let's see if putting the Cavendish before Blueprint better than leaving it at the end. I have a feeling leaving it at the end is probably ultimately the best, but let's see. Nope, it's way better. Okay, we should have been doing that first. Okay. Shows you what my intuition knows. Another magician. I mean, I'm going to keep making lucky aces. Mega standard. We get two. Looking for red seals. We didn't get it, but we get two. We get two kings, which is not bad. A blue seal six is fine, but not worried about that right now. Odd Todd. Oh man. You trigger all final cards played. All played final cards. So that might be what we need to. If it re-triggers everything. All played card in the final hand. Does that activate the Jokers as well though? Or is that just... Let's find out. And get rid of Juggler. Take Dusk. We can possibly blueprint that as well, but I'm curious to see how this is going to work. Our four of a kind. I'm just going to play the four of a kind now. Darn. Over 20 bucks there. And if we get oops all sixes though, I've never given Lucky Cat a chance to work. But with Dusk, it has a chance to re-trigger them again. That's kind of a greedy play, though. If we save all of our lucky cards for the final hand, that's pretty greedy. I feel like Dusk would only work if we had a lot of glass cards. I'm gonna try out Lucky Cat. I've never actually used it before. Let's get the Mega Arcana. Maybe we can make another Lucky Ace. Emperor, the two useless cards up here. I am gonna make another Lucky Ace here, even though this is going to nuke one of our plus multis. It's clubs that are debuffed, right? So if we have any Ace of Clubs, which we have a couple, we can turn them. We can turn these. We actually have a lot of them, so we can actually swap their suits up here. That's fine. These are all bad. They're all bad. I'm gonna sell world card and just, I guess, use the priestess. Hey, nice. That worked out okay. So we lose one ace, we can get rid of that, no problem. Gonna be looking for more of our lucky aces here. And use the star card on the two, so we have it active for the multi with the jack. And let's hope that the lucky ace procs here for Lucky Cat. Good thing we had that stars card. Oh. There is the scaling that we need. Okay, how many kings do we have in the deck though? We only have five. I mean, five's pretty good. I mean, we have to go Baron here. Baron and plus hand size is absolutely needed. So I feel like we no longer need. Like, Lucky Cat's only going to really work out if we end up getting Oops All Sixes, which we don't have. But I think we can effectively get rid of Lucky Cat. Scholar is also something that has been kind of a weak link. The plus four multi isn't really matter. It doesn't, I mean, it does matter, but we can sell it here. We need $18. And we can get to $17. So let's get rid of Lucky Cat, because we definitely need and want Paintbrush. So we buy Baron. Each king held in hand gives a times 1.5 multi. Okay, and then we're gonna save for Paintbrush. All face cards debuffed, of course. Lucky. Okay, so let's see what copying the Baron does here. Now, the only problem with this is that we're playing a four of a kind deck. This would be much better suited if we were just a high card deck. So we can make a couple of Steel Kings, that'd be nice. Plus one hand size passively is so strong here. Then we know we get Kings, which we got one. And use that. We have three lucky aces here. And let's see what this does. I don't know if timesing. I feel like if this would be better here. For this, just because we only have one king here. So I think timesing the family is still better in this case here. Because it's times four instead of at the very most you're timesing by three. We have not had a lucky card proc. Death card is fantastic here. We can make another king. I'd rather copy that steel king that we have. He's an emperor. We are going to waste one here, but that's fine. Yeah, temperance. Look at that. Look at us. Jumbo Celestial. Kind of a ripoff, but we'll take it. Planet X, absolutely. Constellation would have been good early, but it's too late for that now. All right, all face cards are debuffed. The kings don't matter here. Five of a kind matters. That's all we care about. Hey, it procced. Let's go. Minus one anti, minus one discard per round. Well, we haven't discovered this, so I'm going to. Petroglyph. We went back in time again. But we lose discards now. We only have two discards. It's kind of scary. I did that just to discover it, though, by the way. So I'm not expecting us to... No. Not expecting us to get much out of there. I mean, this gets us a planet card. Loyalty card is interesting. Strength card, we can at least make some more kings, so let's do that. Must play five cards, we don't care about that. We gotta get our plus discard back though, man. Okay, we got kings here. We can actually turn this into a king. The odds of us getting our Steel King is very, very low right now. We can just make another ace here, which might be smarter. No, we need kings. We need king. We need more kings. Let's play the queen. Do this. I mean, this isn't gonna get as much, but that was 12K. There we go. I wonder what happens if we do this. The kings play first anyway. They go first, so. That's 3.8 mil. Okay, so let's see if we can get some more money here. We can trim some more, which is something we definitely need. We can make another steel card, but we don't have a king, so. I mean, with so little discards, I think trimming is more important here. Back to a 52 card deck. This is a big nothing burger of a... This is just a big old nothing burger. of a pack here. I guess I'll take a stone card, but yeah, that was not good. Okay, I'm just praying that we get our Steel King. Okay, well, we didn't get a Steel King, but this is going to be a lot of points here. So let's see if putting the Baron before Blueprint in the family is worth more than 3.8 mil. I mean, it's going to be with these, but let's just see by how much. Give us 20 bucks. Yeah, that was worth quite a bit. Get a Buffoon pack here. Don't matter. Okay, well, here we go. So watch this. We can use the death card here. Make another Steel King. We can make another death card with the Fool. I should use a strength card first. Turn these into kings and then made the Steel King. That way we can use both here. We could still use the strength card in case if we get in a bind and needed to make a king out of this, so that's actually fine. Okay, we must play five cards. Got our Steel King. It's exactly what we want. We can copy something over. I don't want a stone card, so. Well, I guess it's better to turn a non-stone card. There we go. I mean, even with just four of a kind here, this should be enough to get us out. And I'm gonna hold onto the strength card in case we get those two queens. Even with this weak four of a kind, I think it's still enough to go out here, especially with the double Steel Kings. Yeah. There's Observatory, so we managed to get Planet X up here, then we're really looking good. I'm gonna skip on the Buffoon pack because I think we're pretty much at full build here. Rare Joker. This blue seal jack could be huge. I'm gonna get rid of this of the two steel cards here because they no longer are stronger than kings here. And we need our aces. I will play this down until we absolutely have to use the strength card. I'm gonna do it. Don't make me game. I will die on this hill. Also, these kings need to be put over there. Okay, so we got an Earth card. We need a Planet X card up here. It's not actually, it doesn't matter. Baseball card doesn't matter here. Get out of here. Okay. We know we can beat 75K. That's not the problem here. Those are aces. This isn't going to make the highest score. Hey, nice. I am addicted to lucky cards. Okay. Jacks do we have? We have five jacks. Hit the road would be interesting with blueprint. But I don't think we can take it at this point. There's our plus one discard. I mean, is the scholar really doing anything here? I feel like it's not really, but just for a plus one discard. Vampire again. Red card doesn't matter. Death card's huge. Double our money first. Too late for throwback, unfortunately. We also haven't been skipping blinds at all. This one definitely feels like it could go off, though. So the scholar was disabled here. We actually have a death card. We can make another Steel King. This is pretty big. Let's create the Steel King now before we have to end up wasting it on like a king or an ace. Yeah, we got a four of a kind, but we want a five of a kind. So the Baron is disabled for this hand alone. I just want an ace. I'm going to play this down to one hand before I play the aces. We will have a five of a kind because they have a strength card, so. Okay, Cavendish has been disabled. I know we can go out. Again, we're not going for the win. We're going for the score. Play one king, one non-steel king. I'll play this down to the very end. Blueprint's disabled. Okay, the family's disabled. We have to do five of a kind here. I am going to use a strength card on only one of the kings, not two. The Steel King's in the back. And even though we're not going to get the family, we're still copying the Baron here. So this is probably the highest we can get. Was without having a times four multi, so we did good. I think that this run definitely has endless potential, but this video is also an hour long, so I'm going to stop it here. We'll get the conclusion of this run tomorrow here on YouTube, and thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. We did a lot of work on this run, but I'm happy with the way it turned out. We're not there yet, but we do feel like we're very, very, very close. We're on the precipice of something amazing here. So thank you for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you click the like button. Leave a comment down below. I think we are still getting better, and I'm happy with the way that the series is going so far. And yeah, this will be one of those times where I think we have to see the conclusion of this. So stay tuned for that tomorrow. And if that one ends up flaming out too early, then we'll just start the next run after that. And thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.